Hi viewers, welcome to Sindh College Lecture YouTube channels. This is Amir Fizada, lecturer in Commerce, Government Girls Degree College, Sakkar. This is the first video lecture on the business communication for the class of BCom, BBA and BS IT Part 2. Let us start with the following contents. These topics will be covered in this lecture. Subject is business communication. So we will start with the what is communication, what is business communication, and history of communication. After that, what are the types of the communication? That are the verbal communication, non-verbal communication, then the formal communication, informal communication, process of communication, and the factors of the communication. Now we will start with the definition of the communication. After understanding the definition of the communication, we can understand this image of the communication. So we are starting with the definition of the communication. Okay, communications is a Latin word which means to share. It is a sharing of information between the different individuals. It includes the sharing of ideas, concepts, imagination, behaviors, and written contents. Means the communication is simply defined as a transfer of the information from one place to another. This transfer of information can be conducted in the different ways. And communication is simply act of transforming the information from one place to another place, one person to another person. And the communication process is the communication is a process of sending and receiving the message through the verbal or the non-verbal means, including the speech or the oral. These include our emotions, cultural situation, medium used to communicate, and even our location. Means the communication is a process of exchanging the information, ideas, thoughts, feelings, and emotions through the speech, signals, writing, or the behavior. In communication process, sender, which is known as the encoder, encodes the message, and then using the medium or channel, send it to the receiver. That is known as the decoder, who decodes the message after processing information, send back to the appropriate feedback or the reply using the medium or the channel. Now, what is the communication? Business communication. Sorry. Now, what is business communication? Means the when sharing of information between the individuals or the entities for the purpose of business, that information, that message, that communication is known as a business communication. Such as information, sharing of the ideas, information or messages for the marketing, brand management, customer relation, customer behavior, advertisement, public relation. It is closely related to the field of the professional communication, the technical writing. Now, what is the history of the communication? From when communication has started? Simply, the verbal communication has existed since the evolution of the languages. History of communication can be seen dates back to the 3300 BC, when the writing was invented and used for the first time in the Iraq. After that, there was an evolution of the different kinds of the writing styles. Greeks developed the phonetic style of the writing, is writing from the left to the right. In 1250 BC, the first ever encyclopedia was written in the Syria. then the postal system, first postal system. In 900 BC, the first ever postal system was established by the government of the China. Later on, other civilization including the Rome, Persia, Syria, Egypt too contributed towards the progress of the postal system. Horses were used to as the main carrier in this very early postal system. They were rely on the stations established relay. The stations established were the horses were required to deliver the information. Then the development of the writing materials. Development of the writing materials. Second evolution of the communication. Previously, there was no concept of the paper. People used to communicate by writing the message on the stones, leaves, bones, and horsebacks. Moreover, there were no proper means of writing. Messages were penned down with a quill and other useful tools. This kind of information exchange was most common in China and Egypt. In 1700 BC, there was some development done to improve the writing surfaces. Otherwise, writing on the stones, bones, and horsebacks were prone to fading in very less time, hence creating the difficulty for the people to understand what was exactly written by the sender. In 776 BC, new idea was introduced to utilize the home pigeons as carrier of the messages, and technique really worked out well. Written messages were tied with the wings of the pigeons, and the pigeon used to deliver it to the intended recipient. It was good as it saves the time and pigeons. Traveling time was relatively less, but it was not a reliable way of communication. The message transfer was solely depend on the well-being of the birds, and if the pigeon was caught up in danger, which was the common occurrence, then the message was wasted. Then the invention of the printing. The printing press next advancement toward the better communication was the invention of the printing technology. Printing was first invented by the Chinese in 1500 BC, and also the first ever writing device, pencil, was invented in 1565. It laid down the foundation for the newspaper printing. Later, idea for the printing press started gaining popularity in the other nations as well. The introduction of the newspaper led to increased interest of the people in printing and so to the advanced communication mechanism. Then the invention of the newspaper. Printing press established by the Gutenberg in the 15th century introduced the idea of newspapers. Newspaper printing was invented. The first ever newspaper was established in England in 1641. However, the name newspaper was not coined until the 1670. The communication is the 19th century. The development in the communication gradually continued to expose the people to new effective ideas and concepts. The beginning of the 19th century saw the introduction of the several new concepts in the world of the communication. By the mid of the 19th century, the fax machine was invented. The year 1876 accounts for the incredible invention of the telephone by the Alexander Graham Bell. This device was different from the previous invention, as it is significant. This device was different from the previous invention, is it is significantly reduced the time required for the conveying the information over the long distance. Communication in the 20th century. In the 20th century, there was an evolution which led to the discovery of the radio, television and broadcasting. Communication was transformed to be conducted through the electronic means. In 1960, communication satellites were introduced. Scientists introduced the different techniques to create the wonders in the communication. Echoes, laser technology were invented. The revolutionized the communication. Bulky telephone transformed into the precisely structured mobile phones. Also, the internet and the web services became the eminent in the late 19th century. So, after understanding the history of the communication, you can understand this picture. This picture shows the picture of the evolution or the development of the communication. Now, types of the communication. Verbal communication, types of the communication, people communicate with each other in number of the ways. They depend upon the message and its context in which it is being sent, choice of the communication channel, your style of the communicating also affect the communication. So there are the varieties of the types of the communication. On the basis of the channel, communications is divided into the two types, verbal communication and the non-verbal communication. Verbal communication means such communications that takes place by the means of the language. Words include the following contents. In verbal communications is the oral communication or the written communication. It means verbal communications divided into two other subcategories. In oral communication, message is sent through speaking and message is received through listening. In the written communication, message is sent to the parties through the writing and message is received through the reading. Now, what is verbal communication? Verbal communication refers to the form of the communication in which message is transmitted verbally. Communication is done by the words of the mouth in the piece of writing. Objective of the every communication is to have the people understand what we are trying to convey. In the verbal communication, remember the short form of the kiss. It means when you are communicating verbally, either in oral, either in written, you should follow this principle. It means you should keep your messages short and very simple that receiving party can understand very well. So, when we talk to others, we assume that other understand what we are saying because we know what we are saying, but this is not case. Usually people bring down own attitude, perception, emotion, thoughts about the topic and create the barrier in delivering the right meaning. So in order to deliver the right message, you must put yourself on the other side of the table and think from your receiver's point of view. Would he understand the message? How it would sound on the other side of the table? So, and as I already told you that verbal communications is further divided into the two types of the communication, oral communication and the written communication. Oral communication means when message is transferred through the spoken words. Words are used. It includes face-to-face conversation, speech, telephone conversations, video, radio, television, voice, or over the internet. In order to send the message in the business, speaking plays the vital role, giving instructions, conducting interviews, attending meetings, sending orders through the telephone calls are very common in today's business. Oral communications is influenced by the pitch, volume, speed, and the clarity of the speaking. And messages, as I already told you, that messages transferred through the oral communications by speaking, and messages received through the listening. Listening means people in the business spend more time in obtaining the information than transmitting it. Listening is the most important way to receive the information. Information regarding the order of the employees, instruction, rules and regulations, customer, trained, etc. are obtained through the listening. But listening people gradually forget 75% of the message after a few days. So, there are some advantages and disadvantages of this communication. Now we are coming to the advantages of the oral communication. It brings quick feedback in the face-to-face conversation by reading facial expressions and the body language. One can gauge whether he or she should trust what's being said or not. There are some disadvantages of this communications. In face-to-face discussion, user is unable to deeply think about what is delivering. Second is written communication. In written communications, written signs, symbols are used to communicate, and a written message may be printed or handwritten. In the written communication, message can be transmitted via the email, letters, reports, memos, and so on. Messages written in written communication is influenced by the vocabulary, grammar, use, writing style, positions, clarity of the language used. There are also some advantages and disadvantages of this communication. First, I explain in detail that the written communications, it is used when the message is sent complex. Complex messages sent, then we use the written communications. Placing orders through the letters, informing employees through the circulars, sending reports and memos, filling different government forms, keeping records in the writing are some examples of this aspect of the verbal communications. It means messages sent through the written communications by writing and messages received through the written communication by reading. Reading reports, memos, policies, circulars, and different business statements are the essential for the organizations. Reading involves understanding and interpreting the materials. Written communications is the most common form of the communication. Is being used in the business. So, it's considered one core among the business skills. Memos, reports, bulletins, job description, employee manuals, electronic mail are the types of the written communications used in the internal communication. For the communications with the external environment, in writing, electronic mail, internet, websites, letters, proposals, telegrams, faxes, postcards, contracts, advertisement, brochure, and news release are used in the written communication. Now, what are the advantages of the written communication? Message can be edited and revised many times before it is actually sent. Written communication provides a record for the every message and sent and can be saved for the later study. Written message enables the receiver to fully understand and it be sent appropriate fully understand and send appropriate feedback. And these are the advantages. There are some disadvantages of the written communications. Unlike oral communications, written communication does not bring the instant feedback. It takes more time in word of mouth. And number of people struggle for the writing ability. Now, the nonverbal communications. Nonverbal communications is the sending or receiving of the wordless message. It means that message is transferred without using the words, such as the gesture, body language, posture, tone, voice of facial expression is called the nonverbal communications. Nonverbal communications is all about the body language of the speaker. Nonverbal communications help the receiver in interpreting the message received. Often the nonverbal signals reflect the situations more accurately than the verbal message. Sometimes nonverbal responses contradict verbal communications and hence affect the effectiveness of the message. Again, nonverbal communication is subdivided. Nonverbal communications have the following three elements. Number one, appearance. Speaker's clothing style, neatness, use of the cosmetics, surroundings, room size, highlighting, lighting, decoration, furnishing. These all convey the messages, nonverbal messages. Body language, facial expression, gesture and posture, sound also convey the message. Horn of the vehicle, volume, speech, rate, these all are convey the message non-verbally without using words. It means that communications without use of the language or the words includes the appearance, body language, silence, and so on. For example, facial expression, we are taking an example. Face and eyes are helpful means of nonverbal communication. They reveal the hidden emotion such as anger, confusion, enthusiasm, fear, joy, and etc. And gesture and posture and movement means the language primarily composed of the hand and fingers. Communication of the deaf people and signal given by the traffic constable are the best example of the posture. Gesture and body movement also indicate many things. Shaking with hand with firmness indicate the warm relation. Moving back, forth reveals the nervousness. And then the communication is divided into two other forms of the communications on the basis of the style. Based on the style and purpose, there are two main categories of the communications and they both bear their own characteristics. Communications types based on the style and purpose are the formal communications and the informal communications. Number one. Formal communication. In formal communication, certain rules, conventions and principles are followed while communicating the message. Formal communications occurs in the formal offices, official styles, usually professional setting, corporate set meetings, conferences undergoes is a formal pattern. In formal communication, use of the slang and foul language is avoided and correct punctuation is required. Authority lines are needed to be followed in the formal communications. It is the language spoken in the office, businesses, other formal places. Proper standard words are used. It consists of specific purpose words like the manager, supervisor, owner, employer, and etc. It is used comparatively less than informal language. It is used when the speaker is relaxed. Now the informal communication. Informal communication is done using the channel that are in the contrast with the formal communication channel. It is just a casual talk. It is established for the social affiliations of the members in organization. Face-to-face discussion. It happened among the friends and the family. In informal communications, use of the slang words and foul language is not restricted. Usually, informal communication is done orally and using gestures. Informal communication, unlike formal communications, doesn't follow authority lines. In an organization, it helps in the finding out the staff grievances as people express more when talking informally. Informal communication helps in building the relationships. It is a language spoken at home or with friends. Improper words are used. It has all purpose words like boss that stand for the various personalities. It is used in daily life. It is used when a speaker is in hurry. So these are the formal and informal communication. Now what's the process of communication? This diagram shows the process of communication, how communication start. Number one, sender's thought. Senders, it means the senders means encoder have an idea. The very first step in the process of communications is generation of the thoughts in the sender's mind. These thoughts may be about the request, order, inquiry, production, or any other activity. Second is the decoding the message. The thought generated in the mind of sender is ambiguous, unable to be communicated unless it is put into the receivable form. This step is known as encoding. Where the sender convert his thoughts into message by means of the language. This is the encoding. Sender have a thought, then put his thoughts into the message. This is encoding. Then after, for example, sender thinks about having a job. Now he will put his thought on the paper. That is called the job applications. In this way, his thought becomes a message. Then the transmission through media. Once thought is converted to the message, it should be transmitted to the receiver through the suitable medium. This media might be the electronic media, TV, email, radio, etc. It may be print media like the newspapers, magazines, letters, or merely sound that is transmitted through the medium of the air. Noises are the barrier. While transmitting the idea to the sender or to the receiver, there may be some barriers, biases in the barriers. While transmitting the information to the receiver, sender faces lots of barrier. These noises and barriers is under five. On the sender side, noises and barrier may take place during the process of encoding. Some of them may cause by the destruction of the lake of the concentration, typing mistake, poor language. On the medium size, in the medium, there may be the barriers. Some barriers are caused by the medium, such as the poor transmission on the TV, radio, misprinting in newspapers. On the receiver side, the receiver can also create the certain barrier to receiving the message, such as a poor reading ability, emotions, lack of concentration, decoding by receiver. These were the barriers of the communications between during the transmission of the message. Decoding by the receivers. Having received the message from the sender, receiver attempt to understand and interpret the message. This process of converting the language message into the thoughts is known as the decoding. For instance, receiver having received the job applications, read the applications and understand the message conveyed by the applicant. This is the decoding the message. Now idea received. As soon as process of decoding is finished, the idea given by the sender is received by the receiver. It means that thought that was generated in the mind of the sender has been transmitted in the mind of the receiver. In our example, as already we quoted the example of the sender wanted to inform the receiver about his thought that having a job. Now sender has gone. Finally, feedback. the process of communications is incomplete until receiver responds to the sender. This response may be negative, positive, or the further inquiry. It means that when the receiver of the job applications become welcomes or regrets the sender, the process of communications is deemed to be completed. This whole process can be depicted through the above diagram. Now, this is the process of communication. Then, what are the elements of the communications which are involved in the process of communications? Communications is the exchange of ideas between the two minds. The process of exchanging ideas is based on these five factors. It's a sender, message. You can see in this picture diagram the element or the factors of the communications. Number one is a sender, number two the message, number three the media, receiver, and feedback. Finally, feedback. Then communication process. These are the elements which are involved in the communication process. Now, who's the sender? Sender is the person who initiates the process of communication. He generates an idea in his mind regarding the production, invention, innovation, request, order, inquiry. So he is the first factor. Sender is the first factor of the communication process, and his function is to generate an idea. Therefore, it is necessary that idea should be clear, convertible into the message. For this purpose, sender needs to apply his knowledge and imagination power. Second, the message. Idea in the mind of sender is transmitted, transformed into the words, is called the message. The sender decides on the length, style, organizations, and the tone of the message. The message may be presented in the many ways, depending on the subject, purpose, items, personal style, mood, culture, and the background. Then the media means channel. The media transmission of the message are electronic media, TV, radio, computer, and the printing media is newspapers, letters, magazine. Media plays a very important, media means channel, important role in helping the receivers understand the message. A wrongly chosen medium can be interrupt the process of communication. Selection of the medium or channel depends upon the message, audience, urgency, and situation. Then the receiver. Receiver is the person who gets the message from the sender and decode it and understand it and interpret it. Feedback. Having understood the message, receiver responds to the sender in yes or no, ask further questions. This process is called the feedback. So thank you, viewer. This is all about the communication, process of communications, element of communications, formal communication, and informal communications. So inshallah, we will meet with new videos of the communications. So thank you for watching.